Hi, this is Ratan Gupta from Knowledge Varsity. Welcome to our video session on problem solving. So here we'll be solving a problem related to time weighted return and money weighted return. Okay, so that is the idea of this problem solving session. So let's see what is the problem. The problem says that investor purchased one share of Goldman Sachs at $100 at time t equal to 0, and again he purchased the same stock at $120 at t equal to 1. Okay. He received a dividend of $2 at t equal to 1 and dividend of $3 per share. Please note that focus on this per share at t equal to 2. Okay. And he sold the shares at t equal to 2 for a total consideration of 260. That means they have specified over here it's 130 per share. And they are asking you to compute the money weighted return and the time weighted return. Okay. So let's see how do you solve this problem. So if you see this time weighted return is nothing but the concept related to geometric mean. And money weighted return is a concept related to internal rate of return. Okay. Now in all of this problem, let's say if we are solving this problem related to time weighted return. So for time weighted return, you need to find out the periodic return. Okay, so the periodic return or holding period return. Okay, and you have to identify when the periods is happening. So here if you see they have specified the period t equal to 0, t equal to 1. But generally we take whenever there is a significant cash inflow. So the idea is significant cash inflow or outflow, we will take the period. Okay, so we'll divide that the entire investment time frame into the periods. Here it's given already t equal to 0 he is buying, t equal to 1 he is buying, and t equal to 2 he is selling. So periods are well defined. Okay, and for money weighted return you have to get the idea of the cash flows. So what are the cash flows that you are getting? Okay, so let us see how to solve the time weighted return, and then we'll get into the cash flows later, that is the money weighted return. So if I draw the timeline looks like this. So at t equal to 0, t equal to 1, and okay, it has gone too far, but okay, t equal to 2. So t equal to 1 he has invested $100. T equal to 0 is invested $100. T equal to 1 he has again bought one more share at $120, but the stock gives a dividend of $2 over here, and the stock gives a dollar of dividend 3 per share, and he sold the shares at 130 per share. Okay, it's useful to solve this problem considering the per share thing. Okay, rather than doing on the total, if you can focus on the per share, that would be better. Okay, so we have to find out the holding period returns for the various periods. So what we have to find out is holding period return first period, that is, this is our first period. So here we will compute the holding period return in the first period, and this is our second period. So we'll come find out the holding period return in the second period. So first period holding period return, second period holding period return. How you'll compute the holding period return? The formula for holding period return is P1 minus P0, that is a capital gain, plus any dividend that you are receiving divided by P0. So that is your holding period return formula. How do you compute this? P1 is a price. Okay, so here if you see, the investor has invested another share at 120. So can I say that the price of the share has become 120 at t equal to 1? So the P1 price is 120. The P0 price is the initial investment price. It is $100 plus the dividend. He has received a total dividend of $2. But here since he has only one share, the total dividend means dividend per share of $2. So 2 divided by 100. So if you compute this, it is 20 plus 2 by 100 or 22%. So the holding period return, first return is 22%. Okay. Now how do you compute holding period return 2? For computation of holding period return 2, again if you see the formula, we'll see P1 minus P0 by, P1 minus P0 plus dividend by P0. But instead of putting this P0 and P1, we'll write P2 ending out for. So it will be P2 minus P1 plus D divided by P1, right? Because this is the price P2 over here. This is the price P1 over here. The price P0 over here. So P2 minus P1. Now what is P2? They have given it's 130 per share. What is P1? P1 is 120 plus dividend of 3 divided by P1 of 120. So that will give you 13 divided by 120. So that is the holding period return 2. Okay, so if you compute using your calculator, it will become 13 divided by 120. So 10.83%. So holding period return 2 is 10.83%. Okay. Now, how do you find out the time weighted return? Okay, so the time weighted return formula is similar to your geometric mean. What we say is you have got a return of HPR 1, you have got a return of HPR 2. So, and so in this case, the time weighted return will be given as 1 plus time weighted return, okay, to the power 2 will be equal to 1 plus HPR 1 into 1 plus HPR 2. Okay. If the number of periods were n, so let's say you had till n 1 plus, so HPR n, so what will happen is for that case, this 2 will become n. So this is for when the number of periods are 2, for n periods, your time weighted return will become this. 1 plus TWR n will be equal to 1 plus HPR 1 plus HPR 2 till 1 plus HPR n. Okay. Now, once we have got this idea, so we'll compute this 1 plus time weighted return. So how do we compute? Let us compute it over here. 1 plus TWR whole square will be HPR 1, 1 plus 22% will be 1.22, and 1 plus HPR 2 will be 1 plus this number, which will be 1.1083, right? So if you compute it over here, so we can say plus 1 into 1.22, so the value will come as 1.3521. okay, so what you have to do is you have to take the square root of this to compute your 1 plus TWR, right? So we can have 1 plus TWR is equal to 1.3521 under root, correct? And that will come as, so you will take the root of this, so 16, so it will be 1.1628, which will imply time weighted return will be 16.28%. So your time weighted return is coming as 16.28%. We will compute money weighted return. So for money weighted return, we need to find out the cash flows. Let's see how we do. Okay, to get the money weighted return, we have to find out the cash flows. See, this is a table for the cash flows. So what we have is, we have drawn here time, the number of stock that you are buying or selling, what is the selling or buying price, the dividend that you are receiving, and this is your total cash flow. Okay, so at t equal to 0, you bought one stock at a price of 100, you did not get any dividend, so the money was going out. Our sign convention is to take negative for outflow, so it is minus 100. At t equal to 1, you again bought one share, the selling price or purchase price was 120, the dividend that you received at t equal to 1 is 2. So you bought a stock for 120, so minus 120, you got a dividend of 2, so your cash flows is minus 118. At t equal to 2, you had two number of stocks, you sold both of them. Okay, the selling price was 130 per share, the dividend that you received was 3 per share, so total cash flow is 130 into 2 plus 3 into 2, so that means total of 266. So in your financial calculator, what you have is CF0 will be minus 100, cash flow 1 will be minus 118, and cash flow 2 will be 266. And you, for money weighted return, you will have to compute the IRR. So let us see how we get that in the financial calculator. So cash flow function, okay, so this is CF0 is our 100 negative, we'll press enter, get down, so we'll go down and it will be cash flow 1 cash flow is 118 negative. Okay, and we'll press enter. Now if you go down, it is asking for what is the frequency of this cash flow. This is only coming once, so it's already by default one is there. We will go down. C02, it is asking, so it is 266, right? So C02 is 266, and we will press enter. Okay. Now to compute IRR, what we have to do is, once we have done this, we have pressed the enter, we will press this IRR, and the calculator itself is prompting you to compute button. So you will press this compute button. So it is giving you a IRR of 14.44. Okay. So what is it has given you? The IRR it has given you is 14.44%. So that is your IRR. So what I've received is IRR is nothing but the money weighted return. So money weighted return is 14.44%. And your time weighted return is 16.28%. One question I need to ask you, so that time weighted return is 16.28%, money weighted return is 14.44%. Okay, so here time weighted return is greater than money weighted return. Now, is it always the case that time weighted return is more than money weighted return, or is it a particular case? What we will say is this is a particular case. Okay. Now, time weighted return can be greater than money weighted, can be equal, can be less than money weighted return also. So it will depend on how the cash flows have performed, how the stocks have performed over the period. Okay, I will give you a small idea over here. Please note that money weighted return is computation of return based on the money that you have in the account, hence the name money weighted return. However, time weighted return does not take into consideration the amount of money in the portfolio. Okay. Now, if you consider the timeline, you invested 100, here you got very high return, 22%. Okay. In the second period, the return was around 10% was the return. So, your time weighted return does not look into how much is your investment. It looks into only the returns that have performed over the year. However, money weighted return looks into what is your investment. Okay, so if you see the investment that you have at the first period, you have 100. Okay, then second you have invested 120 more. Okay, so if you consider this, when your investment was 100, the stock market performed 22% extremely well. But when you increase your investment, so 120 and you have another 120 stock, so when your investment was 240, I will not say investment, but when the money in the account was 240, the performance was miserable, 10.83%. Okay, and what has happened is when your money has increased, so when in the portfolio money has increased, the return has gone down. But when the money was lesser, return was higher. Okay, so increase in money and your portfolio performance is bad. As a result, what will happen is money weighted return will perform poorer than the time weighted return. Okay. That is the idea. Okay. Now, if you want to say, okay, can we have a situation where time weighted return will be greater than the money weighted return? Yes, time weighted return will be greater than money weighted return when, let's say, this guy is instead of 10%, let's say this is 30%. When the performance is better, when your more money is there and return is more, when money is more, return is more, you will find that money weighted return will be greater than time weighted return. That is the idea. So you can test yourself. What I can say is, like, rather than thinking over here that you are selling at 260, let's say you sell at total 360. Just I'm taking randomly. Let's say if you are selling your stock at 180 per share, okay, just compute MWR and TWR. You will definitely find that MWR will be greater than TWR. Okay, just solve it and see yourself. Thanks for seeing the video. I hope you enjoyed watching. Thank you. This is Ratan Gupta from Knowledge Varsity.